Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to our second presentation of the evening, Way, Way Off Broadway! Now tell me, how many of you have been to a melodrama before? Yeah. Great. Then you know, as a member of the audience, you're going to have to do a lot more than just sit there, right? Yeah. Right. First off, let's meet some of the players in tonight's production. First, we have our villain, who is mean, lecherous, greedy, completely untrustworthy, and in addition, not very nice. Do you all know what to do when the villain makes his entrance? That's right, you boo and hiss. And here he is, our villain of the evening, Count von Cliché. Now, as you know, every melodrama must have a hero, and we have the greatest hero yet. He's handsome, stalwart, daring, he's just not very smart. You all know what to do when the hero makes his entrance? Yeah. That's right, you cheer him on in his fight against evil. And here he is, our hero of the evening, Rodney Smythe-Dashington! Tonight, who is as innocent as she is beautiful. She is our heroine, and our response to her is the most sentimental one. We put our hands over our hearts, and we sigh like this. And now, a great big sigh for our lovely lady, Daisy Cornball! Proceeds. And now my show, take us please to Gopher Gulch.
Potatoes for dinner again, Daisy?
Horrible honest folk like us are lucky to have potatoes, Papa. We must be cheerful, happy, and contented about what the sorry deal fate has dealt us. Must we not? Ah, Daisy, you are such a ray of sunshine, and the sole support of our happy little family ever since your father's allergic reaction to work forced him to retire.
Without even a brand new limited edition Alvarez acoustic electric guitar made out of solid flame maple, we get to pass the time.
And the mortgage on our happy little home. Do not fret, dear parents. We may yet make a living of selling horseshoes and gasoline to travelers as our humble abode on the limitless prairie.
Ah, Daisy, your optimism and kindness are an inspiration to your poor old father. Though no travelers passed here in all these years, someone surely will come. Hark, someone knocks without.
Now what, Papa?
Never not find that now. Answer the door. If it's the tax collector, say we're out.
Pardon, Mrs. Intruder. I am the wealthy, charming, beautiful, and distinguished Mrs. Smythe-Dashington, famous society co-sister in the Wicked City. And this is Rodney, my wealthy, handsome, and worthless son.
Daughter,
Daisy. What can we do for you? Our fancy new automobile cast up the wheels you are passing by. We saw your sign and have come to purchase a new tire.
Daisy, get these folks a wheel from the barn and put it on their automobile. I'd do it myself if it weren't for my work allergies.
Yes, Papa.
Wait a minute, Miss Cornball. Allow me. Although I am usually a lazy cat, there's something in you which impels me to do the deed.
Tell us what brought you here, ma'am.
My son and I are looking for land on which to build a branch of our railroad, the Pawnee-Dashington-Fixing. How glad I shall be to get back to the Windy City.
Can we do nothing to cheer your flagging spirits and make the time pass more pleasantly for you? Aha! I have it. I shall now render a charming little song and follow up with a dance of unparalleled grace.
I am cheered already.
I shall put the gramophone on.
Take you away from your humble home, never! Spoil sport.
Schwartz, who's going to be my new bonnet in Gopher Gulch? Daisy, you shall come and lift me and buy a Norris mansion while you climb the golden stairway to stardom off Broadway. You shall be as a daughter to me, and a sister and reforming influence to my son. Wealthy, handsome, and worthless, Rodney Smythe-Dashington. What a splendid idea!
What joy to be with so much good in the world! I might even get to see Rodney without his motoring goggles on.
The high horsepower carriage is ready, Mother. We may now continue our journey back to the town. Very good. Pray allow me to create mercy for the new wheel, Mr. Cornball.
Oh, you dropped the map, ma'am.
Ah, thank you, Mr. Cornball. Little can we afford to lose this map. It shows the location of the new PDQ Railroad.
Did you say railroad?
Certainly, sir. And were this map to fall into the wrong hands, a scoundrel could buy up the property involved very cheaply and then try to sell it to the PDQ at a price which would come very well nigh to breaking us.
Indeed, the scoundrel could have been wind up owning the railroad. Little do they know of the scheme that has popped into my head. The map shall be mine. The railroad shall be mine, along with 91% of Daisy Cornball's earnings. But first, I must shoe my horse. Daisy, the time is at hand for your farewell to Gopher Gulch and hello to fame and fortune.
Farewell, Daisy. Don't forget your papa's guitar and my new bonnet.
Fear not, Mama. No matter how high my star may rise, I shall never forget my poor, honest parents and my humble home.
Okay. Now is the part where you get to sing along. Help us on our journey to the Wicked City. The song lyrics are in your program. Does everyone have the lyrics ready?
Daisy Cornball.
country girl at heart, beautiful and talented though I am.
lock shut. Well, then you have figured out my scheme. But am I to be foiled at this very moment of triumph? No, I have an idea. I shall tie Daisy to the railroad tracks and force her to return the map to me. I come.